I will show you how to like practice a Spark without any installation. So today I will be talking about Databricks. So Databricks is like web-based platform for working with Spark, and you can find this Databricks on like all the three major clouds, that is Azure, AWS and GCP. So today I will show you how you can work with Spark. So for working with that, what you need to do, you need to type on search in Chrome, that Databricks Community Edition, and you can go to this Databricks Community Edition login to click on sign up. So after clicking on sign up, it will, you need to fill some details. So I am just filling some details here. I need to click on this one, and here you can get trial period here. After you can use Databricks on each of the cloud, AWS, Microsoft and Google, but you need to follow some details. You need to enter some credit card and debit card details in order to get this. But if we want to practice for free and we don't want to go for any cloud, we just need to click here, get started with Community Edition. And once you will click here, so we need to select, it's just verifying whether we are a robot or something. So here verification is done. And now we need to go to the email which we have given, and then we can verify this account. Here you can see I got one email and I need to verify this one. So here it's asking to create a password. I will create password. So here you can see I am logged in, and I will show you how to practice here. So here there are two things: data science engineering and machine learning. So if you're interested in data engineering and data analytics stuff, then you need to select this one. So data science and engineering, I will go with that, this one. And here we have the Databricks file system. So in order to use that one, we need to click on setting, and we need to go to admin console, and here we need to go to workspace setting. And we need to enable this Databricks file system, Databricks file browser. So here I have enabled this one. And now if I go to data, then you can see Databricks file system. And here I will upload one sample. Here I will upload one sample file. And this file will be uploaded to the Databricks file system. here you can see this file uploaded here. Now we can check our file. So again, I will going to the data, and then we will going to the DBMS database file system, and here you can say in file store we have uploaded one of the sample files. And now we will go to workspace, and here we can create our notebook. So here I would like to create one notebook, so I will say like movie analysis, and I will use Python as a language. Now I don't have any cluster, so I will just say create. So here like I have created one notebook, but I haven't created cluster like on which the like I will be able to like run my notebook. So first of all, I need to create one cluster. So for creating one cluster, I will be going to here compute, and I will be creating one cluster. I will giving the name of the cluster, and I will like go with the default one, and I will say create cluster. So once the cluster is ready, we will be able to run our notebooks. So in the notebooks, we will be like writing our Spark code, and we will be doing the transformation stuff and all. So whatever the logic we want to write, or like whatever the things we want to do, so we will be writing our logic Spark code in notebooks. So once the cluster will be ready, we will be using this cluster to run our notebooks. So it will take a few minutes just to spin up the cluster. So I will pause the recording for a while. So here you can see now the cluster is started. Cluster like here spinned up. So now I will go to this workspace, and I will open my notebooks, and here like I can write my Spark code. So here I will say like movies data frame, and here I can say Spark dot read dot format, and here like covered file is CSV, so I will write format.csv, then load, and here we need to like provide the path of that CSV file. So I will again go to the Databricks file system DBFS, and here like I can click on that CSV and click on copy path. So here you can say Databricks file system DBFS API is there, so I will just copy this one, and I will say close, and I will go to my notebook, and I will paste this file path. So here I will say here for running the notebooks sale, you can click on this one, run sale, or even you can click on shift enter. Okay, so I haven't attached the cluster, so first of all like I need to attach the cluster, then only I will be able to run the notebooks. So here I will click on shift enter, and here like yeah, you can see my Spark job is running, and I can display can see the content of this data frame. So here you can see, oh, so one thing I forgot, that is like I haven't mentioned the option here. That it is containing header. and also I can write infra schema equal true, so that it will try to get the schema from the CSP, and I will run again, and hopefully in the second time we will be able to see the column correctly. So now you can see that, yeah, we have column, budget, genres, home page and ID. So hopefully I can say this. So in this video I'm not going that much detail to show you how to perform the analytics stuff, how to how to transform the data and all. This video will be just like introductory video, how you can practice your Spark code in Databricks. So basically this will not only give you to give you a platform to practice Spark code, but also if you are practicing the code here, you are learning the Databricks, how to use Databricks on other cloud platform. So in big data project, mostly we are using clouds, right? So if you are learning Databricks here, then you can work easily on any of the platforms. As we know, the Databricks it's getting used more in most of the projects. So Azure Databricks, Databricks on AWS and Databricks on GCP, all of the clouds, these Databricks services are getting used more. So yeah, thanks for watching this video and see you next time.